Hey, Lightroom guy here. One of the things that I really love about Lightroom is that I can customize the identity plate. That is the name that appears on the upper left-hand side that says Adobe Photoshop Lightroom 5 can be changed to my name. In this case, I'm going to show you how it's done. If you first put your cursor over here by the logo, you'll see that there's a triangle that you can click on that will bring down a menu for choosing the identity plate. And when you click on that, it will bring up the Lightroom Identity Plate Editor. Don't worry. Just because it says no options for Lightroom Identity Plate doesn't mean you can't do this. You need to change the Identity Plate pull-down. And you do that by clicking on the pull-down menu and choosing Personalized. This will open up your options for setting text and changing the colors of your text and your module picker buttons. Next, what you'll want to do is just double check and make sure that the radio button is selected for Use a Styled Text Identity Plate, because we're doing text this time around. And you're going to put your cursor inside the black text box underneath and click once inside so that you see the blinking text bar. I'm going to type in my name, Lightroom Guy, and you'll notice that as I type, it's also appearing in the upper left-hand side of my interface. However, it's very small. And in order for me to change the size of my font right now, I will need to select the text I typed, and I'll need to change the size of it by using the pull-down menu with the numbers for the size of my text. I'm going to pick 36. That gets it much, much larger. You'll notice my text here is gray. I can't see it, but it is changing because it is selected, and we're seeing it up here in the upper left-hand side. I want to change my font. I'm going to use the pull-down menu here, and I'm going to look for something that's a little bit more stylized. I think maybe we're going to do Edwardian script. Wow, that's a little weird. So I'm going to go to something a little different. Let's try copper plate. There we go. I like that. And let's choose a lighter face. That's a little better. And I think the size could go up a little larger. I'm going to go to 48. There we go. So I'm pretty happy with this. And you'll notice still my text is grayed out in the text box because it's been selected. Sometimes it's hard to see. But that doesn't mean it's not getting changed up here as you make your changes with the pull-down menus and your size. Next, while my text is still selected, I want to change the color. And you can't change the color unless the text is selected for your name. Here's the color selector button right here. And when I click on that, I get my color menu. There's a number of different options here for picking colors. And I'm going to just use the crayons and I'm going to pick red. And when I choose red, you'll notice immediately my Lightroom guy becomes red. And I'm going to now close this window. And I'm done with setting my Lightroom Guy text right at the top left of my interface. And now I'm ready to do my module picker buttons and change those colors and the font there as well. The difference here is I'm not setting text, so I don't have to select the text in order to make my changes. And to start with, I want to use the same font as I'm using for my name. So I'm going to change that to copper plate right here and change it to copper plate light. So here we go. And if you notice here, this is already changed to copper plate light, but it's looking a little small for me and I want to make that a little bit bigger. So I'm going to change it from 22 to 24 and that feels a little bit better. Now I'm going to change the colors of my selected modules and my unselected modules. The left color button is going to give me the color for my selected modules. And I'm going to choose red once again. And that will be for my selected modules. When I choose the button on the right, that will be for the modules that are currently not being used. And I'm just going to change that for argument's sake. I'm going to change that to this kind of funny pinky color like that. So I'm done there. And at this point, I now have my selected module, the modules that are not selected, with a new font and my Lightroom guy in the top left-hand side. I can select OK at this point, and I am done and ready to start developing and working on my images in Lightroom.